God, the tank is on fire.
Yeah. Crank. Oh.
Howdy folks, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am your host, The Mighty Bjorn, and today for you I have another Community Steel video. Community Steel episode 16. And we're going to be kicking it off with the Marsh Martin by You Want Lasagna. And yes I do, because I'm a fat white guy and I like lasagna. But anyway, let's talk a little bit about his tank destroyer, SPG. I'm not really quite sure what this is supposed to be. It reminds me of a tank destroyer, but maybe it was intended to be an SPG. I don't know. No matter what, I think it's really cool, especially how the turret is designed. And it is 12.11 tons, and it has a 99 millimeter gun, and it's an early war vehicle. And trust me, the gun is quite powerful for an early war vehicle, although the reloads, a little choice. That being said, it's actually pretty cool. I think it's a pretty cool looking vehicle. As you can see, I'm going to sneak up here behind an enemy tank. And well, unfortunately, it took one shot. Let's put one in the engine. And there we go, the Marsh Martin with the kill. And the next vehicle. Yeah, I'm sure everybody went, oh my god, German train again. Yes, folks, it is German train. You all know of Wally, but y'all don't know Willy. This is his Willy. His Willy? Oh boy, that didn't come out right. And it is 7.43 tons, and it's got absolutely no gun to it. And I think it's pretty much all of its weight is nothing but engine and transmission, because my god, this thing can actually get up and go. Yeah, and it's got like next to no armor. You'll find out here in a minute. But it's definitely pretty cool. It's another cool vehicle from German Train, who, man, he must have more time to design tanks than anyone else when it comes to the Sprocket community. Yeah, got some air there, and yeah. Anyway, the next vehicle from Pogdog, this is the TH-13. It is a 9-ton light tank armed with a 50-millimeter gun, and it is an interwar vehicle, and it definitely, it's that kind of feels, it's got the vibes of something that's between the interwar and, you know, actually early war tanks, where you're starting to see some actual tank features you would see in tanks from the early war. But it's also still got a lot of those features that you'd see in the early war, World War I era tanks. Then we're going to pop away a couple shots here. But really quick, folks, if you're not already subscribed, take time, do so. Catch more of these Sprocket Community Steel videos, because they just keep the scene. They seem to keep going, and people keep sending me more and more tanks to show on my YouTube channel, which I appreciate very much. And if you've got a design that you are interested in me showing, send it to me in Discord with the blueprint screenshot. Tell me you want me to show your tank, and I will take a look at it and go from there. Anyway, folks, let's move on to the next victim here. And the next one is the JU-76 Salamander SPG from Kenshi 2900. And, well, this is his 45-ton Salamander SPG. It is armed with a 150-millimeter main gun. It's actually not bad armored. I mean, it's not going to bounce everything under the sun, but it actually does bounce some surprising shots. Its mobility is actually rather decent. It's not horrible. It is a late war vehicle, but it is also a casemate vehicle, so definitely keep that in mind when you're driving around. And look at the size of this gun. It's just ridiculous how huge the gun is. Unfortunately, the other downfall with it is, too, is without actually having an indirect fire mechanic, well, the 20-second reload time is pretty bad. The other thing I didn't really like about this, too, is because of how big the muzzle brake is, it actually kind of blocks your aiming reticle. But other than that, it's really cool looking. I like the way it looks. I like how it's got the front mounted engine, that it's got the case made on the rear, just ginormous gun. And yeah, actually the JU-76, it kind of looks Japanese, to be honest. Or maybe you could even pull it off as Chinese. But you can see here, the aiming reticle is actually blocked by the muzzle brake, which, nah. But other than that, it's still a pretty cool vehicle. The next vehicle I have for here for you is the Type 8 War Dog by Melanus. And it is a 14-ton light tank. It kind of looks more like an infantry tank and feels more like an infantry tank. The hull looks kind of reminiscent to something, but the turret is definitely, wow, that's a different design for a turret. I think it's cool. It's nice to see something different, something that's not like tried and true or a replica of something else. It's, you know, it's kind of like one of those things of, there's things on this tank that feels familiar, but at the same time, it doesn't feel familiar. And it is armed with a 42 millimeter gun. Unfortunately, it is rather thin armored, and well, the mobility's not horrendous, but it's not amazing on this rough terrain either. It's definitely got some difficulties crossing the rougher terrain on some of these maps. As you can see here, I am having some difficulties right now. And all that being said, actually, at the end of the day, I ended up getting it stuck because, well, I'm old and shit, and that's what I do. I always seem to find out new ways of getting tanks stuck in the mud. Finally, the last tank, which was actually our opener tank, is the Vickers MBT by Spooky Time. And it is a 37.64-ton tank armed with a 105-millimeter main gun. It's set for late war, but it's actually during the Cold War. The Vickers MBT was actually a tank that was more or less designed for export. I do believe it was actually originally designed for the British Army, but they would end up going to the Challenger 1 over the Vickers Mark 5, I think, was the Vickers MBT. I don't quite remember. So this is definitely heavily influenced by that, but the hull feels very different. Like, not the front of the hull, but the rear. And the turret feels like right on the money for the Vickers Mark 5. Now, the 105mm main gun is really good. It just slices through everything. Great shell velocity, very accurate. One problem though I noticed with it is, well, the armor is actually pretty rubbish. Like this, I did not bounce a single shot with this tank, so it's not amazing armor. That's kind of one problem you have when you're building a tank this late and it only weighs like 32 tons. There's not really a whole lot of tonnage there to get you armor. No matter what, it's still a rather cool looking vehicle in my opinion. It was definitely cool to see it when I saw it. And yeah, I mean, hey, another one for the British, right? But anyway, folks, that is it for me. Hopefully y'all enjoyed the video. Thank you very much for tuning in and have yourself a wonderful day.